हेलो, वेलकम टू केमिकल काइनेटिक्स रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन टॉपिक। सो व्हाट इज रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन? यूजुअली केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इज द एरिया ऑफ केमिस्ट्री कंसर्न्ड विद स्पीड्स और रेट्स एट विच केमिकल रिएक्शन अकर्स। ओके, एंड द वर्ड काइनेटिक्स सजेस्ट मूवमेंट ऑफ चेंज। We define kinetic energy as the energy available because of the motion of an object. When kinetics refers to the rate of reaction or the reaction rate, which is change in the concentration, that is nothing but change in the concentration of a reactant or a product with time, that is concentration per time second. There are many reasons for studying the rate of reaction. To begin with, there is intrinsic curiosity about why reactions have such vastly different rates. Some processes are there, such as initial steps in the fission and photosynthesis and nuclear chain reactions takes place on a time scale as 10 power minus 12 seconds to 10 power minus 6 seconds. Others like the curing of cement and the conversion of graphite to diamond take years or millions of years to complete. So on a practical level, the knowledge of reaction rates is useful in drug design, in pollution control, and in food processing industries. So industrial chemists often place more emphasis on spreading up the rate of reaction rather than on maximizing its yield. Next, we know that any reaction can be represented by a general equation, that is rate reactants is equals to products, gives rise to products. So this equation tells us during the course of reaction, reactants are consumed while products are formed. As a result, we can follow the progress of reaction by monitoring either the decrease in concentration of reactants or increase in concentration of the products. We have a diagram is there that will show progress of reaction, simple reaction at which A molecules are converted into B molecule. This is so the decrease in the number of A molecules an increase in the number of B molecules with the time are shown in the diagram. In general, it is more convenient to express the reaction rate in terms of change in concentration with time. Thus, for the reaction A gives rise to B, we can express the rate as rate is equals to minus delta A by delta T, or rate is equals to delta B by delta T. Now this is the diagram. This diagram can observe delta is nothing but denoting the difference between the final and initial state of the reaction. So where delta A or delta B are the changes in concentrations, the molarity, or a time period delta T, because the concentration of A decreases during the time interval, delta A is negative quantity. The rate of reaction is a positive quantity, so a minus sign is needed to the rate expression to make the rate positive. On the other hand, the rate is there. The rate of product formation does not require a minus sign because delta B is a positive quantity and the concentration of B increases with time. These rates are average rates because they are average over a certain time period delta T. Okay, let us see the diagram 13.1. The progress of reaction AB at a 10 second intervals over a period of 60 seconds means we have six diagrams, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, six diagrams are there. Only A molecules with the gray spheres are present as time progresses. That means B molecules, red spheres are formed. So this is A molecules. The gray, after that, gradually A molecules are converted into B molecules with the red spheres that was shown in this diagram. This is the time interval. So this is 0 seconds, 0 seconds taken here. This is 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, 40 seconds, 50 seconds, 60 seconds, like this. Now, over the next step, our next step is to see how the rate of reaction is obtained experimentally. Because in 13.2, if you observe the graphical representation, the rate of reaction A gives rise to B represented as the decrease of A molecules with time observed from the diagram. This is graph A. This is graph A. This is graph B. So, if you see, B molecules are increasing with time interval from the graph. So, by the definition, we know that to determine the rate of reaction, we have to monitor the concentration of the reactant or a product as a function of time. For reactions in solution, the concentration of species can often be measured by spectroscopic means. Okay, if ions are involved, then the change in the concentration can be detected by an electrical conductance measurement. So reactions involving in gases are said to be most convenient be followed by pressure measurements. We will consider two specific reactions for which different methods are used to measure the reaction rates. Now, we'll see reaction of molecular bromine and formic acid. See the bromine with the formic acid reaction. See, molecular bromine is reddish brown in color. All other species in the reaction are colorless. That is formic acid and all bromide, all these things. As reaction progresses, the concentration of bromine steadily decreases and its color fades. This loss of color, hence the concentration can be monitored easily with a spectrometer, and which registered the amount of visible light absorbed by bromine. So here you can see this lambda value picture, absorption versus wavelength. If you observe the plot of absorption versus wavelength for bromine, the maximum absorption of visible light of bromine color at 393 millimeters, and as the reaction progresses from T1 to T3, the absorption, which is proportional to bromine concentration, which is decreasing. So this is the graphical representation with the time interval lambda value. Now, you see a graphical in the tabular form, the rates of reaction between molecular bromine and formic acid at 25 degrees Celsius is all taken at 25 degrees Celsius, 0 seconds. We have bromine concentration, rate and rate constant, 50 seconds, 100 seconds, like that they are taken. So this data, experimental data, we can take to find the rate of reactions. Now you see, measuring the change, that means that is decrease in the concentration of bromine at some initial time, then some final time enables to us to determine the average of the rate of the reaction during the interval. So average rate is equals to minus delta T, delta bromine concentration by delta T. The delta bromine concentration equals to final concentration minus initial concentration by time changes, final time interval minus initial time interval. So from the tabular column, if you take a 50 seconds, what is the concentration? Is nothing but 0.0101. initially it is 0.120. so that was substituted in this average rate expression. We got 3.8 to the power of minus 5. So this is we got 3.8 to the power of minus 5 average rate. Similarly, the calculation is made at 100 seconds. We got 3.54 to the power of minus 5 moles per second. So these concentration calculations demonstrate that average of the rate of the reaction depends on the interval, time interval we choose. So by calculating the average reaction rate over shorter and shorter intervals, we can obtain the rate for a specific instant of time, which gives us the instantaneous rate of the reaction at that time. So instantaneous rate of the reaction means at a particular time interval, we can find the rate of reaction. You can see this graphical picture here, instantaneous rate, that is from bromine concentration versus time interval taken here. At 100 seconds, we have observed, at 200 seconds observed, and at 300 seconds observed. So the instantaneous rate any other time can be determined in a similar manner. Note that instantaneous rate is determined in this way. We always have the same value for the same concentrations of reactants as long as the time temperature is kept constant. We don't need to be concerned with what time interval to use. Unless otherwise stated, we will refer the instantaneous rate at a specific time merely as the rate at that time. So instantaneous rate is considered as rate at that time. This is the graphical representation we have. In this, we have observed the time intervals 100 seconds, 200 seconds, 300 seconds. So the rate is calculated, is called as instantaneous rate. Now, the rate of bromine and formic acid reaction now said to be depending on the concentration of formic acid. However, by adding large excess of formic acid to the reaction mixture, we can ensure that the concentration of formic acid remains virtually constant throughout the course of the reaction. So under this condition, the change in the amount of formic acid present in solution has no effect on the measured rate. So how it is possible? Experimentally we can check it. Let us consider an effect that bromine concentration has on the rate of reaction. Look at the data we have, 13.1. This is in this data. If you observe the bromine concentration at 50 seconds, at 250 seconds, we'll take at 50 seconds, this is the concentration, this is the rate 3.52. Rate constant is this one. And moreover, at 250 seconds, if you take 250 seconds, if you take bromine concentration is 0.005 and the rate is 1.75 10 to the power of minus. We can observe when the concentration is 0.01, half of its value change, then the rate also decreases to half of its value, indicating that definitely rate is directly proportional to concentration. So here I can see the same things, that is 250 seconds the rate is noticed, is the value. After that 250 seconds we have one rate is there, that is nothing but 1.75 to the power of minus 5 at 250 seconds, and at 50 seconds the value is 3.52 10 to the power of minus 5. So 50 seconds we have 3.5 to the power of minus 5 is there. At 250 seconds the rate is 1.75 to the power of minus 5 is there. As this is decreasing, this is a reactant, and definitely you can say that concentration of bromine is doubled, the rate of reaction also doubles. Thus rate is directly proportional to the bromine concentration, that is rate proportional to bromine concentration, and rate is equal to k into bromine concentration. Here k is called as rate constant at an instant, constant proportionality which is between the reaction rate and the concentration of the reactant. So this is directly proportionality between bromine concentration and rate, also supported plotting the data. So here this is what we have observed, the rate versus bromine concentration. Got a straight line, this is passing through origin almost. It is versus bromine concentration. The fact that graph is straight line shows that rate is directly proportional to the concentration, and a higher concentration, higher the value of rate. Arranging the last equation, we'll get rate is equals to rate constant is equals to rate by concentration of bromine. So because the rate has the units molarity per second, bromine concentration units molarity, and unit of k will become only happens second and watts or per second 1 by second 1 by time interval. So it is important to understand that K is not affected by concentration. So as we will see, for a given reaction, K is affected only by change in the temperature. So here, to ensure that rate is greater than higher concentration, greater at higher concentration and smaller at lower concentration by ratio. So ratio also, if you check it, the ratio is nothing but rate by the concentration ratio remains same provided the temperature does not changes. So at 50 seconds we calculated the rate that we got is 3.4 into 10 to the power of minus 3 seconds. You can use this data to calculate K, and a slight variations of values K listed in the table are due to experimental data deviations in the rate measurement. See, we got 3.4 into 10 to the power of minus 3 is there, but this is the 3.4 into 10 to the power of minus 3 is there. Any small variation is there, that small variation is because of the experimental measurements deviations. Okay, this is one picture we have, that is the rate of hydrogen peroxide decomposition measured with the manometer, which shows the increase in the oxygen gas pressure with time interval. That arrow, whatever the arrows are showing, that arrow showing the mercury levels in the YouTube. So that's what we'll see the equation now, the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide is one of the products of reactants of gas. Then we can use the manometer to find the reaction rates. Considering the decomposition reaction of hydrogen peroxide at 20 degrees Celsius, this is 2H2O2 gas as 2H2O plus O2. In this case, rate of decomposition can be determined by monitoring the rate of oxygen evolution with manometer. As in the diagram we have shown, this is the diagram for manometer arrangement. So the oxygen pressure can be readily converted to concentration using the Idle equation. Idle equation is PV is equal to NRT, where concentration of oxygen is N by V. So N by V can be calculated, that is 1 by RT into P. And rearranging, we'll get this is 1 by RT into P, and these are the molecules. This is 2 moles of hydrogen peroxide, and we got this is 2 molecules. This is water molecule, these 2 are water molecules, and these 2 are hydrogen peroxide, and this is oxygen. So for that, this is a graphical reference. If you observe over the y-axis, if you take this pressure in millimeter Hg and time interval on x-axis, then this is the slope we obtained, that is 0.12 millimeter Hg per minute for hydrogen peroxide. That is instantaneous rate constant, rate of the reaction. So here, this instantaneous rates for the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide at 400 millimeters will be given, is given here. This is 400 millimeters which is given, the tangent multiplied by 1 by RT. So here, this rate of reaction which is given for oxygen production is equals to delta concentration of oxygen by delta T, that is equals to this 1 by RT delta P by delta T, and which shows increase in the oxygen pressure with time, and the determination of instantaneous rate at 400 millimeters, expressing the normal units we have, that concentration per second will be converted into millimeter Hg per minute to atmosphere seconds. Then we'll multiply the slope of tangent delta P by delta T with 1 by RT as shown in the equation. Another one. See, what is the next thing is the reaction rates and stoichiometry. In this, we have seen that stoichiometry is simple equations A gives us to B, and rate can be either expressed in terms of decrease in rate reactant concentration with time interval minus delta A by delta T, or the increase in the product concentration with the time, that is delta B by delta T. For more complex reactions, we must be careful in writing the rate expressions, considering the example, that is 2A gives rise to B. The 2 moles of A is disappears for each mole of B that forms, that is the rate at which B forms is half the rate at which A disappears. So thus, what will happen? Rate of A with respect to A will become equals to minus 1 by 2 delta A by delta T, or rate with respect to B will become equals to delta B by delta T. As per the stoichiometry, both are equal. So in general, if you take any another equation like AA plus BB gives to CC plus DD, for this also the rate, stoichiometric rate equation can be written like this, that is minus 1 by A delta A by delta T is equals to minus 1 by B delta B by delta T is equals to plus 1 by C delta C by delta T is equals to 1 by D delta D by delta T. For products we are writing positive sign, for reactants rate we are writing negative sign, indicating that making the rate completely positive always, for the reactant rate before that we are putting minus, but rate is not always, rate is always positive, because this minus indicates reactant's concentration with the time is decreasing, concentration is said to be increasing with the rate of reaction, because final value for the reactant concentration will be small value and initial value for the reactant concentration is big value. So their difference is minus. To make rate is positive, we are putting minus before that rate only. Now we will see a problem. Write the rate expressions for the following reactions in terms of disappearance of reactants and appearance of products. See, I minus aqueous plus OCl minus aqueous gives Cl minus aqueous plus OI minus aqueous. This is the first equation we have. For this reactant, we have I minus is there. So rate, you can write minus D by minus delta I minus by delta T, which is equals to another reactant OCl minus is equals to minus delta OCl minus by delta T equals to product where Cl minus is there, that is delta Cl minus concentration by delta T equals to another product we have delta concentration of OI minus by delta T. So this is the disappearance of, these are the minus signs will indicate the disappearance of reactants, and positive delta by delta T is indicating the appearance of products. Appearance means forming, disappearance means they are consuming in the reaction. Second reaction, if you see, that is 4NH3 plus 5O2 gives rise to 4NO plus 6H2O. So in this, all are gaseous substances only. For this, the coefficients, we have different coefficients are there. Ammonia we have 4 is there, and oxygen we have 5 is there, nitric oxide we have 4 is there, and water we have 6 is there, H2O, steam we have 6 is there. So in this, rate expression will be written by writing the reciprocals of these numbers as coefficients of the rate of the particular substance. So ammonia rate, before that we are putting minus 1 by 4, and before oxygen rate putting minus 1 by 5, before NO appearance putting 1 by 4, and before H2O appearance putting 1 by 6. So this is the stoichiometric rate expression, and plus and minus how we are writing is to express the rate of reaction in terms of change in the concentration of reactant or product. We need to use the proper sign. What is the proper sign for the reactants? That is minus. For products, it is plus. So this is for products, plus is for products, and minus is for reactants we will use. And that is another equation, another example we have, that is formation of nitrogen pentoxide from nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. Suppose a particular moment is given during the reaction, molecule oxygen is reacting at a rate of 0.024 molarity per second. First question, problem is at what rate nitrogen pentoxide is being formed. Second question, at what rate NO2 reacting. These two things we have to find. And after writing the rate, stoichiometric rate constant, rate equation, we will get minus 1 by 4 rate of NO2 is equals to minus delta oxygen by delta T. This is rate of oxygen, this is rate of nitrogen, and this is rate of N2O5. In the question, they are given the oxygen rate, that is 0.024. So that oxygen rate, if you substitute in this above expression, we can find this N2O5. So in this expression, between oxygen and nitrogen, if you put that value, then nitrogen appearance can be obtained as 0.048 concentration per second molarity per second. Similarly, the second question, what they are given is what rate a NO2 is reacting. So NO2 rate means NO2 rate and N2O4 rate, these two we have to take. So in this, what will happen is we have minus 1 by 4 delta concentration of NO2 by delta T is equals to minus concentration of O2 by delta T. You write, then easily you can substitute that oxygen constant, oxygen rate in this expression, as this 4 goes this side. After that we will see the rate of disappearance of NO2 as minus 0.096 molarity per second. So second question, what rate NO2 reacting? So we know only the rate of oxygen given in the problem, so that we have taken. Or else you can also take the N2O5 rate, which is calculated in the first question, that is 0.048, to find the rate of the disappearance of NO2. So two alternative methods are there, anything you can use, and finally you'll get 0.096 molarity per second. Thank you. Hope this small concept in chemical kinetics is enjoyable. So we will see in the next session with interesting rate chemical kinetics topics.